रिकॉर्डिंग सब कैन स्टार्ट।
हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वी स्टडी लास्ट टाइम अबाउट द एंजियोस्पर्म्स। स्टडी एंजियोस्पर्म्स I told last time about the properties of the angiosperms. So we have to study today. We have to study about the life cycle of the angiosperms. Life cycle of angiosperms. You know that the angiospermic plants is sporophyte or gametophyte. It is sporophyte. So plant. We can image any plants. We can image the plants of the mango tree. Plant is sporophyte. We see that is the leaf, root, stem, etc., etc. In this plant, having the flower. Plant having flower, and flower consists of male reproductive part and the female reproductive part. This is male reproductive part. Male and female reproductive part. You know that some plants are bisexual, some flowers are bisexual, while some flowers are the unisexual. But we have to consider here male and female reproductive part. Male reproductive part of the flower. You know that it is anther. Flower consists of anther. And next part is pistil. Next part is pistil. This is male reproductive part, and this one is the female reproductive part. This is male reproductive part of flower. This is female reproductive part of the anther. You have seen the anther. Anther such diagram is there, and such type diagram is there. Anther. This is male reproductive. This is, and this is filament. This is anther, and this is filament. We are considering only this part. This is main productive part, anther, and this main productive part, anther, consists of pollen cell. Pollen cells. Pollen cells are structure which produces the pollen grains. So pollen grain, and it is also called as the micro sporangium, and this is pistil having ovule. Ovule. And because pistil consists of, if you see the structure of the pistil, it is consists of this is a flask cell structure. This structure, this is called pistil, and it is consists of three parts. It is consists of three parts. This part is stigma. This part is pistil, and this part is ovule. This is stigma. This part is pistil, and this part is ovule. Is found here, or ovules are found here. Ovary contains more than one ovules. So this is ovule. Suppose we are seeing here, this is the position of ovule. This is ovule. This ovule is also called as the megasporangium. It is also called as the megasporangium. Megasporangium, and this is also called as the microsporangium. It is called as the microsporangium pollen sac, and this is called ovule. Is also called as the megasporangium. I told you about the position of the ovule. This structure is ovule. Stigma, style, and ovary. This is ovule, and ovule. This is structure ovule. Ovule is found inside the ovary. It is also called as megasporangium. And here in pollen cell, pollen mother cell is there. In pollen cell, pollen mother cell is there. And in this case, in ovule, is four mother cells. In here, in this ovule, a spore, which type of spores? Megaspore mother cell. We are using the term as the spore mother cell. But here, used as the microspore mother cell, and here megaspore mother cell. So we use that here megaspore mother cell. Megaspore space is less. So mega spore mother cell. This mega spore mother cell, and here pollen mother cells. This pollen mother cell undergoes into which cell division? Meiosis cell division. Undergoes into meiosis cell division. Meiosis cell division to produce 4 microspores. It producing 4 microspores. We are not writing in actually here. Megaspore mother cell undergoes into meiosis division. Meiosis or the reduction division to produce 4 megaspores. It produces 4. This process takes place here. This process takes place here inside the ovule. Inside the ovule, megaspore mother cell is present. This megaspore mother cell undergoes into meiosis cell division to produce 4 megaspores. Out of 4 megaspores, out of 4 megaspores, 3, in most of the cases, generally cases, out of 4 megaspores, 3 megaspores are destroyed. 3 megaspores are abortive, and 4th, only single megaspore become functional. This is out of 4 megaspores, 3 megaspores are abortive, are destroyed, and only 1 megaspore functional. So here, this is megaspore, and this out of 4 megaspores, we get. So this is the 4 megaspores, and these megaspores out of 4. 1 megaspores become functional, and it produces female gametophyte. It produces female gametophyte, and while in case of the microspores, this microspores ultimately converted into pollen grains. It is converted into pollen grains. Pollen. In this case, all the 4 become the functional, but here only 1 become the functional. Only 1 remain the functional. 3 abortive. While in this case, all the 4 become the functional. So it produces embryo sac or female gametophyte. This female gametophyte consists of contains and this is embryo sac. Where this pollen grain after germination, it is pollen grain, and this pollen grain generates to and it contains two male gametes. It contains two male gametes. This is called as male gametes. So you see here, this is structure is female gametophyte, and this structure is male gametophyte. Talking about the male gametophyte here, you can observe here, this is pollen grain which is germinated. And here it contains two male gametes. These are the male gametes. These are the male gametes. This diagram. This is the diagram. This is pollen grain which has germinated. So and this is female gametophyte. If you draw this diagram of female gametophyte here, detailed, this is female gametophyte, it consists of three cell structure this side and three cell structure this side. Three cells are here. We can rub this diagram up, which is and this structure is egg. Egg are female gamete, and this cell and this cell, both cells which is formed on both sides, these cells are part of the synergids. And these cells are called the antipodal. These cells are called as antipodal. So in between the two cells, one cell is there. This is called as the female gamete. This whole structure is called female gametophyte. This structure is called as the female gametophyte or embryo sac, and it contains one egg and both side of egg synergids. Two synergids and one egg, and in between polar nuclei. In between, this is polar nuclei. Polar nuclei. This is polar nuclei. This is structure of female gametophyte. This is male gamete. Sorry, this is female gamete or egg, and this is male gamete. So we have studied up to it. This is detailed diagram of this, and detailed diagram of this one given, and this detailed diagram of the pollen grain. So we can run this diagram. So this structure is found inside the ovule. One process is there by which pollen grains are transferred to female reproductive part of the flower. So by the process of pollination, by the process of pollination, pollen grains are transported to the stigma. By the process of pollination and body pollination, the process by which pollen grains are transferred from anther to stigma. It is another matter. Let us discuss about the self pollination and the cross pollination. Let us discuss. So here, by this way, pollen grains are transferred, landed on the stigma, and here the pollen grains germinate, and after germination, this pollen tube enters inside the style and ultimately reaches to the embryo sac, and inside the embryo sac, both the male gametes are released. Both male gametes are released. One male gamete fuses with egg. One male gamete fuses with egg. And this process is called same gamete. While other male gamete fused with polar bodies and make a triploid structure. This event is called as double fertilization. So what I tell here, male gamete this structure is supposed this is female gametophyte, and here male gamete comes and fuses with the egg. And what it produces? It produces the egg plus male gamete. This producing zygote. Egg, it is applied, and this is also applied, and this is 2N. And this polar bodies plus male gamete, they producing endosperm. They producing endosperm. This is 3N. This is a triploid structure, because one nucleus is here, one nucleus is here, nuclei are there, and one nucleus from it is consists of two nucleus. They triploid. Two nucleus is there, two nucleus is there, two nuclei and one nuclei. Three put together to form a triploid structure. This structure is called the endosperm. This zygote ultimately converted into embryo. This ultimately converted into the embryo, and while endosperm provide nucleus to developing embryo, endosperm provide nucleus to developing embryo. You know that the endosperm develop before the development of the embryo, because Endosperm provide nutrition to developing embryo and any nutritive tissue. This is replied. So you are familiar to endosperm, what coconut water you are drinking. Coconut water, this is endosperm. What you are drinking, coconut water, this is endosperm. And what you eat, the coconut, this is also the endosperm. So endosperm is nutritive tissue and this provide nutrient to developing embryo. So here, by the process of pollination, they reach here and they fuse together to perform the process of fertilization. So this is, in this egg, there is egg and another structure is there. This is male gamete. They fuse together to produce the embryo. Embryo. This produce embryo, and this embryo ultimately, this embryo, this is this embryo ultimately producing the main plant is producing. So this is the life cycle of angiosperm. This is the life cycle of angiosperm. So this is plant. And what happens after the fertilization? What happens after the fertilization? What is the fate of fertilization? Fate of fertilization. What happens after fertilization? Phoenix and corolla. Phoenix and corolla. So Felix and corolla, tip part, dry and fall. Dry and fall. Felix corolla and endosium also. Felix corolla, Felix and endosium. This dry part. And seed, ovule develops into seed. Ovule develops into the seed and ovary develops into fruit. Ovary develops into the fruit, while ovule develops into the seeds. And embryo is found inside the seed. Embryo is found inside the seed. So and you have seen some fruits having no seeds, because these fruits are produced without fertilization. Such fruits are called as the parthenocarpic fruits. So this is the current name. This sector is called as apical gametophyte or oocyte. This is embryocyte or male gametophyte. So that's for today. Next time we will discuss about the life cycle. So if any query, any question, you may ask me. If you want any question, you may ask me.
No, sir, no doubt.
No doubt. So that's for today. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.